this is the beginning.
Josef, how are you?
Oh, all good today.
Feeling good?
Feeling good.
Okay.
Party was great, but
everybody knows Santander. Everybody yes. knows that business. I'm not sure everybody here knows Isar Aerospace. I've heard the story. How about we just share a little bit more about what your company does and the amazing things it's creating?
Yeah, so Isar Aerospace is actually quite a new company, founded only in 2018. Out of Munich, the Technical University Munich.
That's a bit different than 160 years that I heard and 120 years that I heard. So 5 years.
Yes, unfortunately, I'm not 160 years old, so I couldn't have founded the company then. We're actually only 5 years old. The idea was in 2018 to make a company in Munich that is actually making rockets. So rockets in order to transport satellites into orbit. I met my co-founders there. I met my first 10, 15, 20 employees there. And since then, we had grown our company to today almost 400 employees.
Almost 400 employees, fast growing, literally putting satellites into space. I know that the journey with SAP started in 2020 through the Catalyst program. Tell us a little bit more about a fast-growing business like yours. Why choose SAP?
Yes, so in 2020, we were actually still quite a small venture that we had there. And our first primary concern was, of course, not to introduce an ERP system. So
argue that might not be the right thing, but I'm glad you did.
Absolutely. So, and we're glad today that we did start talking with SAP already in 2020. So we were a company of, I think, 30 people back then, and none of them with any experience in this field. So we were a lot into development. We were a lot into getting our technology forward. But we had started the collaboration with SAP already. One of the things that Isar Aerospace actually takes a huge pride in is we have, for a startup, very untypically, a large production capacity.
Yes.
We have logistics companies, so we have actually our entire value chain, starting from development, through production, and through the entire rocket operations, we have everything in-house. So, and in order to support that, we were, as I said, very happy to have started already the talks with SAP because we need such companies, such organizations that help us actually build a digital system that supports our development, our production, and our rocket launch operations.
Yeah, you truly were a business that is designed for future-proof. You leverage the SAP platform, S/4HANA public edition, to drive your business, not only for the 30 person, but as you say, you're at 400 and growing very fast. If I'm not mistaken, second half this year, you're launching the pilot of the rockets, but you're looking to do 10 rockets a year. Tell us a little bit more about the challenges that sort of fast growth places on your business.
Yes, so as you already said, we're a fast-growing company, which is a challenge in itself. We are planning to ramp up directly after a successful first flight to about 10 rockets. You need to understand our rocket has 10 engines. On 10 rockets per year makes 100 engines. For a small company like us, so today we're not in serial production. We're not experienced in that. Mm. And we were looking for partners. We are looking for partners to help us facilitate this growth, not just as an organization, but also as a business. So the space industry, I was saying, does not have any experience in that or a lot of experience in that today. It was the last few decades. It was a very state-driven industry. So we have seen huge programs like the Apollo program in America, like the Space Shuttle program. In Europe, we had the Ariane program.
Yes.
But one of our things is, and that is where we work together with SAP, is really making a business out of this.
And so just to build upon that a little bit, I mean, when you look forward and as you're growing and the hundreds of engines that you're having to build, what does it mean to be future-proof for Isar? And what's the role that SAP needs to play to help support that growth agenda that you have?
Yes. So our future proofness basically comes from being competitive. So I mentioned these programs that we had that were financed by the state. Our idea is to have it financed fully privately and being a self-sustainable business. So, and for that, in order to facilitate this mass production that we have ahead of us, we need to have programs like SAP, companies like SAP support us in facilitating all this growth, all this production, to also have a repeated quality. You know, rockets are inherently in danger to explode.
We don't want exploding rockets.
No, not too many of them, at least. It becomes a.
Okay, so you can have a couple. I didn't know that. We can have a few exploding rockets, but just not too many.
Oh, yes, it happens. I mean, it's difficult to explain to the customer sometimes.
I'm struggling with this one as well.
I'm pretty sure SAP doesn't explode, but...
I really hope SAP doesn't explode.
So, yeah, but we really hope that SAP is helping us in not exploding too many of our rockets, so...
You can be assured there'll be no exploding rockets at Isar with SAP, Josef.
Yeah, yeah. Thanks a lot for that promise.
All right. In all seriousness, it is quite amazing. You're actually building an industry. We were talking pre-show about the space industry and the fact that it has been in a regulated form, but now you're creating a commercial market in its own right. We know it was a leap of faith in 2020 in a small company, a venture, where you weren't quite sure of your future. And I know there's still a lot of obstacles to overcome. Josef, the fact that you've placed trust in SAP, building the foundation to help you scale and grow, we are so proud of the partnership and we wish you the very best. We look forward to an incredible future for Isar. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much. Thanks, everyone.